For Saturn days, nights, 294th draw, our maker had set the plumb line for his Amos chapter 7 plumb line for at 137 zillion or 137 million. Quite remarkable. 294 is 9 months and 24 days, but is 9 months and 24 days is 294 days. But all quite remarkable, because earlier that day, 4 hours earlier, he orchestrated the 148th running of the Run for the Roses, aka the Kentucky Derby. And how this ties into this, going back to how he wove in American Pharoah and Mr. Z into the Triple Crown races, starting with the Run for the Roses 7 years ago, and 4 years ago, Justify winning his Triple Crown, and he'll be Justified, and all this, all the details, every news story, everything is he's woven into his end time timeline. But he causes me to speak about certain things, including how this saga of his Amos chapter 7 plumb line, and this Run for the Roses that he orchestrated this year is quite remarkable, and I'm going to share some things with you, and how it lines up with today's 409 waypoint. This, the day that the famine prevailed, and 28 days later, Nebuchadnezzar began the four-day process of burning Yahweh's houses, burning the houses in Jerusalem and Yahweh's house. But it's a four-day process that lasted to 510, which is 31 days later after today's 409 waypoint. And today's 509 on Satan's calendar, paralleling the 509 waypoint of the Danites calendar, where they commemorate the destruction of his houses and such, and how that ties into the singing at the Western Wall and stuff I'm going to get to. Hopefully I'll see it in my notes. And but just a truly, truly remarkable day on his restored calendar, and lining up with 509 and the day that the Russians commemorate this Russia Victory Day of their Great Patriotic War and stuff, the victory of their Great Patriotic War. And I made an error in the last video saying that that today ends the 77th anniversary of World War II. It's what Russia claims was their victory. And 116 days later for the Wave Homer on 9/02 is the day they officially recognized when Japan surrendered as the end of World War II. But 9/02 is the day that he brought the wife that's fled in the wilderness to bring forth the Emmanuel Manchild into the world and his three siblings. And also, it's actually the default frequency for this recording device I use for these videos. And I didn't choose that, but quite remarkable, because it ties into Strong's number 242 for day number 902 on his restored calendar. And give ear to the near kinswoman, because he's telling you to listen to what she's telling you, because she stood with Yahweh's anointed. And quite remarkable. I came out earlier today to beat the wind, but it didn't work. He sent the wind earlier than normal, and it actually blew well into the morning hours of last night. But but then it quieted down early hours this morning. Well, around probably around 5 or 6 o'clock or so, started quieting down, but then it picked back up again. So, but they're not supposed to be as bad as yesterday. Yesterday was pretty bad, 55 mile an hour gusts, and today's only supposed to be 45 mile an hour gusts. But anyway, this whole thing, I'll get on the video, a lot of notes to cover. I'm going to try to stick to the notes, so hopefully cover. But he calls a long shot that he caused to be named Rich Strike to win this 148th Run for the Roses on that same day that 137 Powerball for those three men I talked about, Moses and Aaron's father, Amram, and Levi himself, and Ishmael being 137 years old. But Rich Strike, a.k.a. Striking It Rich, but it being the 148th such race of the Run for the Roses parallels his 528 Elisha trek that he caused me to accomplish with his Ezekiel chapter 10 rolling thing 309 days earlier. Truly remarkable. His 309 on this was the last day, of wine on 309 on his restored calendar, which is day number 69, which means stone. Strong number 69 means stone, and he's tied that into this as well. But 528 on his restored calendar is day number 148 for this 148th Run for the Roses. And this is about this, I'm going to get into this, Elijah dream vision back then, the sand, the seashore vision with Sarah, with the cashing the tickets, Actually, there are two different dreams. That's the 717 dream, the Sand on the Seashore dream, excuse me, which they're cashing the tickets. But it ties into the cash of the tickets, and that's what I had on my mind when I said that, but I'm glad I caught that error. But it's two different dreams. That was 717, and this was 528 with the Elijah, with this this party at this mountain of mountain ranches. So anyway, day number 528. 528 is day number 148 on his restored calendar, and 309 days later. And 309, day number 309 is 11-9, the day he brought me into the world. On Satan's calendar, on the great Meher Shalal Kush Bazmir, he brought me into the world on 8-12 on the Danites calendar, which I also focused on at the beginning of last video, which I'm going to get to. But 11-9, 1962, of course, being 8-12 on the Danites calendar, was a big part of that video, because it was 594 days. Day 12 waypoint, which is the 266th day, was 594 days prior to that. And I want to make sure that I got there. Is it the day before 266? To that day before waypoint that I was talking about in the video. But and it was 595 from this other. But anyway, that was the point of the video, was the 594 days from the previous day, which was 406 on his restored calendar, which was the three smooth stone anniversary of the 1335th day of his from the 1260th day. Anyway, but I spoke about this at the beginning of the last video, and in the previous video as well, I spoke about it in detail. But 309, like I said, was the last night of the wine in this current go around, and tonight will be night number 30, which is huge with how it ties into Hosea chapter 5-7 for the 5-7 waypoint of the 148th run for the roses, which was that last 137 zillion beginning of it, plumb line. But anyway, but that was the last night of the wine in the King of Kings wine cellar, but it's about ready to be refilled because there's been a 33rd box sitting in storage waiting to get up here, but hasn't been able to be accomplished on account of you steal from a maker. But anyway, that brought us to today's 409 waypoint. The famine prevailed, and the city was broken up in relation to today, the 509 waypoint. Well, 509 waypoint, 509 on Satan's calendar. 409 on our Maker's Restored calendar is day number 99, paralleling the 99th year of his servant Abraham's life when he gave him the name Abraham, and he cut the covenant of circumcision with him and told him he's going to, that a year later he was give birth to when he was 100 to Isaac. Well, he wouldn't give birth, Sarah would. He gave Sarah the new name that day too. But also there's 99 days after Yahweh caused his servant Noah let loose the dove, the second stroke. 99 days left to 227, and I'm going to say this 227 is huge in this because he opened the door of the three tiers of the boat, and tonight is the 817th night of no wine total. And day number 817 is day number 227. So that's absolutely huge that tonight's the 817th night of no wine on account of you stealing from our maker. So tonight's the 227th night of no wine, if you will, if you want to use the great Meher Shalal Kush Bazmir, because he mirrors Satan's calendar, his calendar, back and forth onto his end time timeline. So it's just in his calendar. That's just what it is. But I said 4 hours earlier was this run for the roses, the 148th roses, but it was actually 3 hours and 57 minutes earlier. For that 357, the uncircumcised Philistine to the south says he's going to kill me with the 357, I got the 357. Ooh, it's I'm shaking in my boots. And I actually said, well, you better get to shooting, see which one of us dies, because Revelations of his two sons says that any manner that someone seeks to kill me is a manner they're going to die. So anyway, but the race was scheduled to go off at 3, post time was 3:57, but it didn't start until 4:02. And the draw on the Powerball is 7:59, so that's 3 hours and 57 minutes later was the draw. Anyway, they don't get around to drawing it probably with all the pre-stuff until 8, but they list the draw at 7:59, the time they start the broadcast. Truly remarkable. Because what did he cause to be drawn? The first two balls, because you can watch that. I can't watch the Mega Millions live. I can watch it after the fact, but I never do. But I always, they list the balls from the lowest to the highest, but that's not the order they're drawn. The order that they were drawn was number 5 and number 28. 3 hours and 57 minutes later from that 3:57 post time, which didn't, they didn't open the gate. They're off at 4:02, which has significance too, because that's the fig anointment. The fourth fig anointment waypoint is the 4:02 waypoint. So day number 92, and if we open the door to the 3:2 of the boats, 92 days after he caused his servant Noah to let loose the third dove, the dove of the third stroke. But anyway, 5:28, he caused to be drawn, and that the first two balls drawn, with that Elijah truck on 5:28 being day number 148. Can you really make it up? Can you really make it up? Well, after that, he caused the number 6 and the number 67, then the number 4 with the bonus ball of 10. For the second stroke in a row, the bonus ball is 10. Previous Mega Millions was as well. But 5:28. Day number 148 on Omega's restored calendar. And of course, this is all, his end time timeline is all about his restored calendar, because it's about returning back to him, do that which he's restored, including his restored calendar, which includes his Sabbaths and the rest of his restored appointed times on him, including all males shall appear before his face as 3 strokes a year. And we're approaching that second stroke of the Feast of First Fruits, a.k.a. the Feast of Sevens, just 19 days from today. Yeah, 19 days from today on 4:28 on his restored calendar. Anyhow, which is day number 118 of the year, which Psalms number 118 says, they're going to gather around me like bees do, and I'll circumcise your hearts. I'll circumcise you, I'll circumcise you, I'll circumcise you. And it also says I'm not going to die. Well, anyway, if you look at the every other number, 5, 6, and 4, because he caused it to be 5, 28, 6, 67, 4, but the 5, 6, 4, every other number, equals the year, the month, the day, and the hour. Well, you say, wait a minute, you say that means 565. Yes, but ever since I've said that's 565 days, I have said that he's going to cut it short, because his word says so. After 6 days, he's going to cease on the seventh day. So it's 564 days of this, which the 564th day is 9:10, the delivery waypoint, because the 565th day would be 9:11. Actually, I take that back. I got that wrong in my notes. The 565th day, I think, is 9:12, and the 564th is 9:11. I think I got that wrong, actually. I think the 565th day is 9:12, I'm pretty sure. So he's going to cease on 9:11, which is where this all is. Meher Shalak Kushbas probably started, on 9:11 on Satan's calendar, 2001. But I mentioned that that race was the 28th night of the wine. He caused the number 28 to be drawn in the second slot for the 5:28, the 28th night of wine, which he does things like that all the way through these draws. And then the third number was 6 and then 67. 6 means to perish or to be destroyed, but 67, I want to try to keep this going a little faster. I'm already going slower than I wanted to, although I might be talking faster than I wanted to. But Strong's number 67 is the morning of the dual Egypts. Mizraim, or what they call it, but the morning of the dual besieged places, because Egypt means besieged place. The morning that means the United States and of course, the physical land of Egypt, just like Jerusalem is split into dual Jerusalems, dual teachers of completeness. But the morning of the dual Egypts, and that's where they mourn for Jacob for 7 days, after they had mourned for him for 110 days. Well, 40 days of embalming plus 70 days of mourning in Egypt. And he caused the 5-ball total last night to be 110. Coincidence. So we go to, and it caused the 67 to be drawn in the fourth slot for the morning of the dual besieged places. 7 days. What did I talk about on that day? 7 days flowed out from 7:30 a.m. the next morning, the end of that day. But 7 days of recutting his, of continuing to cut the 3-smooth-stone anniversary of him, of the 434th or 483rd day, and 7 more days following to the 490. That takes us to 414, that ends at 7:34 a.m. in the morning of 4:15, which will be 5:15 on Satan's calendar at 7:34 a.m. in the morning, Arizona time, because that's where he's risen up his house. You gotta be kidding me. So 67, the morning of dual besieged places, drawn, and I talked about it on that day, that night, and I talked about the 407 waypoint, which is 507 on Satan's calendar. I talked about it, plus 7 days equals the 490 day, about him testing him now for the 3.5 days, which now today, this morning at 7:34 a.m., one of those 3.5 days is gone. And it ends off 411. It ends up 4/11 on which is the Operation Grapes of Wrath waypoint of 1996, the first day of the 16 days of Operation Grapes of Wrath on 4/11. And it's also the day that the 40 spies came back with 10 of them gave their bad report. And of course, Yeshua, aka Joshua, and I go through Caleb. I just about had another brain dead moment, but gave the good report. And of course, they were allowed to enter into the land of the promise. Wow, well, I talk about that 3.5 days, and they get to the 7 days of the morning for Jacob, at the morning of the dual besieged places, at the threshing floor of Atad, which I'll get to. Starts number one, 110 days before that, and before they load up the wagons and everything, five ball total, 110. But the crossing, Strong's number 110 parallels, they crossed the Jordan on 110. This is about me crossing the Jordan to cash the tickets. They crossed the Jordan on 110. Elijah, of course, crossed the Jordan, cast his mantle to Elisha, his replacement, both for symbolic of his anointing, because his word's written upon me. And of course, they we set aside the Passover on 110. I'm going brain dead now. Yeshua rode into Jerusalem on the colt of an ass on 110. And then Genesis 49 says that his second son's going to come to you riding upon the colt of an ass as well, which ties into the Shechem Ridge and the conception of these children and everything else, which I'm not going to get into. I have in other videos. But Strong's number 67 is beyond the Jordan. They had to cross the Jordan to get to the morning of the dual besieged places to mourn for 7 days. And we're in these 7 days. It's just remarkable. The threshing floor of Atad. Atad is Strong's number 329. The previous night on 406, the Mega Millions, 135 for the Key of David. The numbers calculated for that night's draw to 329. You got to be kidding me. And here we got it coming up the next day with the 329. Well, also this, the serial number of the Elijah Dream water tank on that 521 waypoint. The serial number was 12-14-03-687. Well, 12 ties into setting the trifectas, if you will, for this race, this 528 race. Excuse me, this 507 race. The first day they started burning that houses down on the mirror, the Nebuchadnezzar did. Well, because the 12-14-03, if you take 1 plus 2 plus 1 plus 4 for 12, 14 plus 0 plus 3, that equals 11. And that, but you look at it this way, you look at it 12 plus 14 plus 3, that equals 29. 11, 29, which is, he's woven the 11, 29 waypoint a couple years ago in his restored calendar in a huge way. It's day number 329. You got to be kidding me. But he's woven this serial number into his Urim and Thummim numbers with two sets of trifectas, if you will, the 12-14-3 and the 687 for this race, tied in all symbolically to this Elijah dream I'm going to get to, because it's quite remarkable. But with his Urim and his Thummim with these lottery tickets, because 687 for the second trifecta, if you will, the trifecta's picking the first, second for win, place, and show to get in that order. But 7 plus 8 plus 7 for the second half of that Elijah dream, that 325-gallon water tank that was crushed in that dream, well, that adds up to 21. Well, Striking It Rich, a.k.a. Rich Strike, was number 21. Wait a minute, they only allowed 20 horses in the race. I'll get to that. He was number 21. But the first of the trifectas, if you will, the 12, number 12, Taiba, was ridden by Big Money Mike, who rode Justified to those Triple Crown races. You got to be kidding me. But Taiba is a Muslim word that means to repentance, basically. It means to turn back, to be repentance. It's a female's name, but the horse was a stud colt, but it was a female's name, but it means repentance. It means to turn back, and that's just right. But then 14, at 12-14, Barber Road. You got to be kidding me. Had me shave my hair off on 124, the Michael waypoint, which was followed the first steamboat eruption on 123. And 124 is the Daniel 10:21 waypoint for Michael. For Michael, I talked about that 10:21 in detail in the last video, the day of this race. 10:21. That Daniel 10:21, Michael is going to be the only one that sees it with him. But Barber Road, I shaved off my hair back then in Greece, all of my hair, per Ezekiel chapter 5, and the five was the first ball drawn night before last. But Barber wrote, his morning line odds were 30-1 for these 30 days, but how that ties to Ezekiel 5 is amazing. For the show place of that trifecta, the number three horse, who got second, but number three, 03, epicenter, you got to be kidding me, went off at 4-1, but his morning line odds were 3.5-1 for the 3.5 days, and for the 4 days, because 3.5 day rounds up in this case to 4.11, if it starts on, because the way it starts the next morning, if it starts on 4.07, you had 4 days, but epicenter. You could call that Steamboat Geyser the epicenter of all this, really, all the symbolism he's woven in this with that 123 first eruption of these now 153 eruptions, the third of the fifth year. But quite remarkable. But epicenter, I said the third of the fifth year, and this is the number three horse. But boy, because Yellowstone's going to blow. You watch this all happen. But the second trifecta, if you will, the 687, the number six horse is Messier. Messier, morning light odds were 8-1, parallel to 81, talked about the 81st day in that video. But Messier is a French guy who discovered these 110, I told you the five ball total was 110 that night for the 110 years, but all the other 110s that I couldn't think of a minute ago, 110 years of his count of the flood, Noah was marked after 110 days after he shut off the rain, and the waters kept coming up from the ground. Joseph lived to be 110 years of age, and Yeshua lived to be 110. Plus, you have other things at 110. He gave his Ezekiel measurements for the first day of the 10th month, those chapters 40 through 48 for his end time son of Adam prophecies. And I could go on and on with that as well. But the crossing of the Jordan is the focus of today's video. But this guy Messier, it's these fuzzy objects or galaxies. By the way, I've never said it in this video, but his name of it, he caused me to get a company. And actually, I might leave that out. There's a reason I might leave that out for now. But anyway, 110 fuzzy objects, but galaxies or clusters of stars up there. But 110 on me discovered that's what Messier means. Number eight for that place, charge it. Well, in my past life, I had a problem with charging it. Jake Ways removed my iniquity from me, but reality is it's just terrible, a terrible past I have. But when I look at the word charge it now, I think of Yahweh's charge. He says, Abraham obeyed my charge and obeyed my Torah. And you say, wait a minute, he didn't give the Torah yet. He said, he obeyed his pathway. He still gave Abraham waymarks, and Torah just means pathway, like signs, turn left, turn right, go straight, slow down, curve ahead. Road signs, road maps, like a road map, a map, if you will, into his kingdom. Not so much turn left or turn right, because we're not to turn to the left or the right of his straight and narrow path. But if his word tells us to go to the right, we go to the right. But we're not to turn to the left or the right from it. But anyway, but Yahweh's charge. And Abraham, when Yahweh talked to Isaac, he said, "Your father Abraham obeyed my charge, and he listened to my Torah," which you failed to do. But that's why they go charge it. And the number seven, crown pride. And of course, the crown ties in the crown of Joseph and stuff, but the pride is on your end. So see, there's a negative there with the positive and the negative. Is you're just lifted up in pride and arrogance above the testimony of his word. And you think you wear a crown, you mean you're going to get in his kingdom. Well, his prince is standing before your faces. And he talks about my crown in his word and Joseph's crown, which is referring to my crown, and talks about the crown of these first four offspring and such. But he doesn't talk about your crown. He says you're not going to get a crown because you haven't obeyed his charge. You haven't charged it according to him. You haven't charged life according to him. You've charged your life on borrowed time is what you've done. You've borrowed your life. You've charged your life. You put it on a credit card that it's about going to become null and void because you ain't going to have any money to pay for it because you're going to cast your gold and your silver in the street. But anyway, the outcome of the race was 21, I told you, for the Daniel, the 21 days of Daniel, those three sets of 7 days, and the second place, the place was number three, but three sets of 7 days of the affliction, Daniel's affliction, for that Daniel, that 124 Michael White point, that I shaved my hair, Barber's Road, but 124 back then in Greece, of the year 5772, but the outcome was twenty-one It brought forth this restored calendar, by the way. The shaving of the hair started 3 days later, earlier on 1/21. But anyway, it was the third day I shaved my hair. But the outcome was 21/3 for those three sevens, and even 21 is three sevens, of course. 21/3, 10 for that 10 bonus ball he caused to be drawn that night and the night before. That third spot, and the fourth place horse was 13. And 3 and 10 are 13, and 13 doubling that. But Striking It Rich, the number 21 horse, Epicenter, followed by Zandon. Now, this horse was named this 3 years ago, before Brandon come along in the picture, that euphemism for Biden. Let's go, Brandon, with a polite way of swearing, whatever, a non-polite way of swearing. But Zandon, he called Mr. Z, talked about American Pharoah, Mr. Z, called me Mr. Z, Zandon. And he's about, a lot of people are going to be saying, let's go, Zandon, type of thing to me, because you're going to be, you'll be cursing his anointed. 96.6, repeating 6% of you are. And that number 13 horse was Simplification. He's kept this simple all the way along. Just said, believe his word. Believe, he tells us Michael's going to be sent to us from Greece. Daniel 10:21, and he caused the 21 and the 10 to get first and third. And don't get simple this, and Michael can come to you from Greece and tell you what's recorded in the scriptures of truth, and not one's going to seize with them except for his servant Michael when that happens. Daniel 10:21. That's simplification. But the only reason that Striking It Rich was in the race was because Ethereal scratched earlier in the week. He was a backup. They had 20 horses, a field of 20, plus two backups, 21, 22. But Ethereal scratched. So 20 of the 22 race. 2022, that's this year, isn't it? Oh, coincidence. 20 of the 22 race. But anyway, the other names of the race were outstanding as well. I'm only going to talk about a couple of them, but all of them were, every one of them. But Ethereal means celestial or heavenly. The upper regions of space, basically. It can refer to ethereal beauty, meaning airy type of thing. But it means celestial or heavenly, like his dual heavens. And that's scratched. So that's what you've done. You've scratched your place in the eternal existence of his dual heavens. That's just reality. That's what that ethereal. You want to hear real reality, real. What's real is you've given up your eternal life for the things of this of the world, like Esau did. That's reality. Descendants of Esau. But anyway, and 3.3% of you is going to turn back to him and live, putting the emphasis on Epicenter. And boy, that 3.33 was amazing for that day. I'm not going to get into that. But since he caused the 5 and the 4 to be drawn also in that draw, there's no 67 racehorse, but he caused the 5 and the 4 to be drawn. The 4th was the last number drawn, but I'll mention their names. Smile Happy, and happy is he who waits and touches the 1335th day. And 406 was the 3 Smooth Stone anniversary of the 1335th day, the day before the race. But 406 is huge in this, with day number 96 for those 96 pomegranates that was in the last video. And number 4 got dead last. And number 4 is Summer Is Tomorrow. And how that ties into that 654 summer ending waypoint before. But Summer Is Tomorrow. And summer ended dead last in that race. And Jeremiah said that prophecy for the summers ended and were not delivered. And that prophecy I talk about in this video. And the summer fruit wine. But now we got the summer fruit wine is tomorrow. And I'm doing this video today, not that day of the race. But anyway, summer's tomorrow. But the significance of 654, that end of summer a few years ago, was on 822, the Hurricane Michael waypoint, which was 10-10 on Satan's calendar of 2018. But on that Hurricane Michael waypoint, I petitioned Jabway those 3 strokes a day of those Daniel petitions, 3 strokes a day. And it was day number 654 of me doing so. And that means that I made the 1962nd petition. He brought me into the world in 1962 on the day he sent Hurricane Michael. Now, can you really make that up? So that's day number 654. I approached to him every day, so I couldn't skip a day and get there. That was day number 6. And how did I know that he was going to send Hurricane Michael that day? But day number 654, me approaching near to him, 3 strokes a day, per Daniel's 3 strokes a day petitions, produced the third petition, was number 1962. Can you really make it up? I spoke about the two pillars, Yakin and Boaz, in that video 2 days ago, the day of the race, the Run for the Roses, number 148, that he caused 148 to be drawn the first two balls later that night, 3 hours and 57 minutes later, and causing 528 to be drawn, the Elijah Trek waypoint. And of course, Elijah Trek with Ezekiel 10 rolling thing is the same as the dream I'm talking about with the truck I was making in Bertha, the big old truck that he'd given us to drive at that time. But talking about this brothers, Yakin and Boaz. Yakin, it's only two letters difference how I spell it. Yakin was the trainer of two of the horses of those dual trifectas. Number six, Messier. Number six for, and number 12, Taiba for repentance. And Messier for those celestial objects, those 110. And of course, it's about crossing the Jordan and me riding upon the ass of the colt, and they crossed the Jordan on 110. And he found those 110 celestial objects. Messier, that Frenchman. Number six and number 12 used to be trained by Bob Babbert, who also trained American Mr. Z and American Pharaoh 7 years ago and Justify 4 years ago. But he's banned from races from drugging horses, cheating, and he's had 34 horses in the Derby for the 34 chapters of These Are the Truths. Everything about his career is amazing. White-haired man, amazing stuff, the things. But 7 years ago for American Pharaoh winning the Triple Crown, and the 4 years ago for Justify are huge. American Pharaoh still, and Mr. Z chewed off American Pharaoh's tail because they were stable mates. But all that, but Yakin is the new trainer because Baffert couldn't train him, so because he's banned for the track, so they gave him to a different trainer, and Yakin used to work for him. Yakin used to work for him years ago. He's on his own now, so they found a way to put those two horses in his barn, but they were in Bapper's barn, at least one of them was 6 weeks ago. I'm not sure the other one. So 6 weeks prior, they moved at least one of them, or maybe both of them 6 weeks prior, probably the cutoff time, but he can't have any direct contact with Baffert and different things. But truly amazing, because Baffert had that, won the Triple Crown with that American Pharaoh and with Justify. But truly, truly remarkable. Because Triple Crown, there's only been, oh boy, now I can't even think, nine winners in the 148 years of its existence, I think. But I'm not sure about the 148. I don't know if the Derby's the oldest one or the youngest one. But anyway, it's been a lot of years, and there hadn't been that many Triple Crown winners. But those two horses won with one trainer anyway. But last year he had what was that horse's name? Disqualified. He won the Derby with that horse, and there's a racehorse in there that's similar. I thought I would get to that name. I must have already skipped past it. Number 11. I'll get to it. Number 11. But anyway, he had a horse disqualified last year. He won the Derby last year, Baffert did. But he had it taken away from him to win. But what about striking at Rich a trainer? We got Baffert's replacement, Yakin. When I talked about the Yakin for Yeshua and the Boaz pillar, those two pillars with those 96 pomegranates. They were 400 pomegranates, but then they were 96 on each row for 192 on each crown. The crown, one of my crown, the Boaz one to the north. But striking Rich's trainer, what about that? His last name is Reed. Didn't I talk about Reed earlier that day in that video, 70-70? That 70-70 measuring Reed, that 11-foot Reed. Didn't I talk about that in the video too? And then Mr. Reed wins it a few hours later after I recorded that video. Can you really make it up? The measuring Reed that's 11-foot because of the armhole cubit, that 679 that Jeremiah has lifted up from the armpits, the armpit cubit, that 22-inch cubit versus an 18-inch cubit, and the cradle stone is 18 inches by 22 inches. Anyway, I'm talking way too slow for this, way too much information. But number 11 ran 19th for the 11-foot Reed. He ran 19th out of 20 horses, 1920, 192 for the 192 pomegranates in that video. And it was day number, the day before on that 1335th day on 4-6 was day number 192 I was referring to from 924, I'll shake the dual heavens and the earth, waypoint, the epicenter, 192. You could actually call it 192, the epicenter, if you wanted. But 19th out of 20 horses he ran for 192, just taking away the zero. And his name is Pioneer of Medina. Medina Spirit is the one horse that was disqualified at Baffert's last year. You got to be kidding me. But 192 was the five-ball total of the previous draw. on day number 192 from the 24th day of the ninth month. 192 was the five ball total of that draw the night before on 406, which is the 1335th day. Three smooth stone anniversary of the 1335th day. You got to be kidding me. The five ball total of 192 plus 10 for the bonus ball is, of course, 202, which I also talked about that. And that also tied into the race, but I'm not going to get into it. Number 19 for the 19th place. Tonight's the 19th darkness of the Abraham lamp. Genesis 15, the 400 year for those 400 pomegranates, cha-ching prophecy. Wow. Ha. And of course, there was four pomegranates missing on each of those rows, of those four rows. So there was only 96 of them for the, on each pillar, on each row. So there was only 192 on each crown. When Nebuchadnezzar came to break them down. And when did he come to break them down? During those 4 days of 507, mirroring 507 on Satan's calendar, the day of the race, to 510. Ha! 510, those 4 days. Ha! There's four pomegranates missing. And this all started, the first bottle of wine, the first bottle started with pomegranate wine. That was a gift to me that was bottled in the mountains of Ararat. I kid you not, it was a gift bottle. 19th night of darkness for that struggle number 19, the point of the sword of Ezekiel chapter 21. Wow, coincidence that striking it rich was number 21 in relation to the 21 days of Daniel. Striking it rich went off at 80-1 odds. Say what? The second longest shot in the history of the Kentucky Derby. When I talk about day number 80, Moses day number 80 and the 81st day for the court case number and such. Yeah, I did. Again, and expand upon that in that last video. Moses 80th day, and I talked about the 608 in relation to the 158 URL the day before, or the video before, and the 158 for the 718 as well. But the Nazarite vow, the 80 days of the vow, Moses appeared before Pharaoh's faces, 80th year of his life. It was day number 80, 320, when he appeared to before his faces to let my people go. And then the next day, on 321, he on day number 81, he turned the waters into blood. Yeah, we turned the waters into blood, of the waters of the Nile. Yeah, all coincidence. Keep hanging in there, because I'm going to get to the 321 a little bit more. Maybe sooner than later, I don't know. I don't know how long it's going to get, but it don't matter if you listen to it or not. It ain't going to keep it from not being true. Number 21, 21 days of Daniel. I talked about that with the Michael. Daniel 10, 21, waypoint. Win, play, show. I talked about that. 21-3-10. 21-10. 10-21. Wow, Daniel prophecy. 321 was the prison mattress. Written on my prison mattress those 17 days I was in prison on County Steel from Gateway. Wow, 321, the day number 81, the day he turned the waters into blood. Wow, you got to be kidding me. What about 10-3? Jungling the numbers up. 10-3 was the first anointing waypoint for me to be king. Does that upstairs anointing? And also, 10-3 is day number 273 for those 273 difference between the Levites and the firstborn of the rest of Israelites that had to be redeemed for 273 times 5 shekels each for the 1,665 shekels, 1,365 shekels. But 273, there's 273 bottles of living waters now. Total of those now, 448 bottles. 448 bottles total. And 273 of them were the living waters, symbolic of the living waters. 272 of those were drank. But 273, because the one bottle I'm wearing, of those 273 bottles. You got to be kidding me. What about 21-3, juggling up the order? 21-3, day number 213, is 803. 803 was the second anointing for me to be king. Oh, yeah, these race results were coincidence, huh? I'm feeling the big cha-ching jackpot. Jackpot indeed. Second anointing. Since the 21 doesn't equate into days of the months of the year, we'll just convert it to the 24-hour clock. So it's the 9 o'clock hour of the p.m. hour. So 21 converts to 9 o'clock when you convert it to the 24 o'clock. Convert away from the 24 o'clock to the 12-hour clock, 9 p.m. So what about 9-3? Oh, that was the delivery waypoint of the 280th day for Emmanuel Manchab Herschelab Kushbez and his three siblings back with the younger wife. And now we got 9-10. For the 9-10, you got 3, you got 21-10, 21-3, and 21 becomes 9. You got 9-3, you got 9-10. 9-10 is the delivery waypoint now. Oh, yeah, coincidence. That race results in coincidence. Well, about 921, since 9 is 21, well, that's the three measures of leavening that was hidden for 217 days. You've got to be kidding me. Since the flood on 217. 310, day number 70. I talked about day number 70 in the last video. The jackpot, I definitely hit the jackpot with this 148 run for the roses. Whether you can sense that or not, that's your problem. The NBC announcer said they just won the jackpot. Oh, excuse me, they just won the lottery. Say what? They didn't win the lottery. They won a horse race. They just won the lottery. He's all ecstatic about this long shot winning. He said a bunch of amazing stuff too. I didn't go back and listen to it a second time, but that one made me forget everything else. They just won the lottery. Say what? Didn't he know he was watching a horse race? And the rest of the stuff he said was amazing too. I'm going to go back and listen to it. I just haven't had time. Yesterday's a Sabbath, and I didn't want to listen to it on Sabbath, but I go back and listen to it because it was incredible. Number 10 for that third place, Zandon. I talked about it. Amazing. He was wearing a blue jersey, what do they call them, silks, but with five white stars on his back. It showed him running away with these five smooth stones. And he says the Star of David is going to come, and now Balak did in prophecy in Numbers. But it's quite amazing. And of course, the ten bonus ball the night before, and the 10 bonus ball that night were amazing. But the 310 and 310 is 13 and 13, doubling the 13, which is just remarkable as well. The emphasis he put upon that, and even the emphasis on the 313 with Tel Aviv is remarkable. I'm trying to move along because I got to step up the pace because this might be the world's longest video for me. Justify winning the Triple Crown on 419 plus 1,428 days was this race, and yes, it was this race, and 11, the strong number 1,428, so only used one place. It's used with the 11 Gadites for the 11 horse I talked about a little bit ago, but 11 Gadites, Gadites means fortune, 11 fortunes that passed over the Jordan's overflowing banks. Wow, talks into Zion Banks, and I always say Zion Bank, but I noticed the other day it's actually Zion's Banks. It's actually Zion's Bank with the S. It's a division of Zion's Bank. And I talked about those three words that are translated, the stone markers that set up in a dry and parched land. Jeremiah 31 sets up Zion's, plural, Zion's to mark the pathway, his highway, his Isaiah chapter 35, highway of holiness. And the first race to the third race of the Triple Crown, third race is 35 days later for Isaiah 35, pathway of holiness. But he set up, but they've overflowing banks, as in Zion Bank, Zion's Bank, for those Zion's. Wow, banks, cha-ching, in the first month. The first month, when did they cross the Jordan? In the first month, on 110. 110, five ball total that night. So anyway, the 11 fortunes that passed over the Jordan's overflowing banks in the first month to put to flight those of the valley in both the east and the west. Talk about the east and the west of Jordan. See, Elijah went one way, Elisha went the other way. I got to go back and forth. The east and the west, the valley. And they're talking about those 11 men that stood. And what words for stood is 30, 33, 20. And stood with David. It's about Yahweh. Listen, give ear to the near kinswoman. Stand with Yahweh's anointed. That video was 33 minutes and 20 seconds on video on YouTube. And that Strong's number for stood, one of the Strong's number for stood is 33:20. But it actually does say stood with that verse, but they did stand with him. Wow. 11 fortunes, 11 foot reed. Reed, the trainer of striking it rich. And of course, I don't want the money. I want you to listen, Kingway. I don't care about that. I want you to just shut your mouths. And I know that this will be the beginning of him shutting your mouths. So you shut up and listen to Kingway's anointed. And so standing with David, wow, all this symbolism about standing with David isn't coincidence. These 11 men standing with David, come on. Give me a break with that whole thing about 1,428 days prior for that justifies Triple Crown on 419. Amazing. Just truly amazing. And 419 is day number 109, which is significant as well. All right. But the video, when I recorded the video, was actually 33 minutes and 19 seconds long before YouTube made it 33:20. And Zerubbabel finished Only used one place in Ezra. Zerubbabel finished 33:19, the second house, on 12:3, which is day number 333, which is huge in this. Day number 33:33 on our Maker's Restored calendar. But Zerubbabel, Zandon, let's go, Zandon. Go ahead, Mock, see where it gets you. Anyway, that 528 trek number, day number 148, Elijah trek was trek number 186 with his Ezekiel chapter 10 rolling thing. Gets the coals into my hand. The coals tied in the race too. I'm not going to, I didn't write it down. So I would get into that one probably if I had more time or if I remembered it. But 6 months, 186 days and 6 months and 6 days, tying into the 6 months and 6 days of the 6 years, 6 months and 6 days of that video. Truly amazing. And I told you that the number 6 and 67 were drawn in that order. It was 528 for the Elijah trek. 667. Strong's number 667 is a brood. Oh, Jerusalem, Jerusalem, how I would have gathered you under my wings as a hen does gather her brood, but you wouldn't listen. You wouldn't listen. Instead, you stoned those that were sent to you. You did. Your ancestor did. You'd do the same if you get by with it today. Matter of fact, I haven't only been threatened with the 357. I've been threatened to be stoned. I've been threatened to be eaten by bears, lions. I've had lots of threats over the last 10, 12 years, whatever it's been, I guess, of these threats, going back to 12 years, going back to 2010. When he sent me to Greece, I think the first threat was in 2010. And a guy's going to fly there to Greece and find me, to kill me. Of course, I don't think he told me how he's going to kill me. That guy didn't. That was just a blanket threat. I don't know if he's going to use a 357 or bears. Probably couldn't have got a bear in a suitcase. But he could have bought the one bear that had his backpack full of stones looking for me. And he was actually one of the six men of Ezekiel chapter 9. Number one of the six of all things. 110 for the five-ball total plus 10 is 120 for six-ball total. 120 days in 4 months. 4 months until the harvest, Yeshua said. Brings us from the third month to the seventh month. And the Feast of Ingathering of the seventh month. That extended feast. The 4 months of him raising me up to be king. Raising up his throne to be king here. And the 120 days at Horeb of my two predecessors, Moses and Elijah. Tying into that Yeshua appearing to... Whenever he had that vision that he shared with Peter, James, and John, at the private mountain, because Moses was on Horeb for 80 days and 80 nights, and my predecessor Elijah was on Horeb for 40 days and 40 nights, and they both were capped off by 81st day and a 41st day with Elijah wrapping his face in symbolic of my face is shining. 121 was the first day of our Maker's Restored calendar. He flowed out from that, the high day of the feast, that day number 7 of his feast of that which is unleavened of the first month. And it's the high day plus 3,678 days is today. What's Strong's number 3,678? Throne. Gotta love it. 75 men went partway up Horeb that day. 70 elders, Aaron and his two sons, makes it 73. And Moses, 74, and Yeshua went with him partway up as well and waited for him the whole time, actually. Yeshua, a.k.a. Joshua. So that's 75 men. Today's day number 75 of the war. Abram departed when he was 75 years of age, and I'm getting ready to depart and cross the Jordan. Just reality. Talked about 509 being Russia's 77th anniversary for the 77s of Lamech and such, but their victory day. And how that wasn't World War II, I already covered that. How that wasn't actually technically the end of World War II. It was Russia's end of World War II, if you will. And Russia's day today. I don't know. I haven't seen any news yet what they're doing with their big victory parade. But I did read an article a few days ago about the numbers of their tanks, their model numbers and stuff of their tanks and their airplanes they're using. It's phenomenal how it ties into the Testimony of Kingway's Ward and the here and the now. But I didn't write any of them down, and I've got too much stuff anyway. But the 116 days later for the wave omer, Gateway still waving his omer before your faces right now is 116 wave omer, tied into the count 50 prophecy, takes us to his feast of first fruits, aka his feast of sevens. That's 19 days from today. But anyway, so 902, I talked about that, 1945 and 902. The wife that's fled in the wilderness, she's going to 902, 8 days later, she'll give birth to these children from the day 902 on Satan's calendars when she was born. but the mirror would be should be given board to him on the night of 10-7, which would become 10-8 already, because at midnight Satan reckons the days from midnight to midnight. Anyway, which becomes 9-11 at sunrise, but if you mix the days, 9-8 or 10-8 is 9-11. But of course, this is about the mirror of mirroring the two. But anyway, it's interesting that 8 days later, from 9-10, they'll be circumcised. The three man childs will be circumcised, and that's 9-18. And 9-18 is actually the day that she left that corner lot 60. The wife fled in the wilderness. She's already fled in the wilderness because she'd already been removed from that 55. But she we were still on a corner of a piece of property. And then we fled with them looking for us. But anyway, that's truly amazing. All right, so 10-10, the last two bonus balls. Zedekiah's ninth year, Nebuchadnezzar came and pitched against him on 10-10. And then 9-11 was the next year, 567 days later. So that's 80 days left of that year, that ninth year of Zedekiah, 368 days of his 9-10, the 10th year. And then equals 440 days, plus 127 days for Sarah of the of that 11th year of Zedekiah, takes us to the 507 waypoint, day of the race, so the day of this last draw with the 507 was 567 days after he pitched on 10-10. And structure number 567 is the iniquity of the Amorites for the Genesis 15 prophecy for the iniquity of the Amorites, 400 years. 400 days prior to that day was 227. I talked about tonight being 817, which is day number 817 and no wine, which is 817 is day number 227. But 227 plus 400 took us to that day. What about today? Today's 229, the arrest waypoint, plus 400. Takes us to today's 409 waypoint. And I talked about 229 in that last video. The Amorite, iniquity of the Amorites. And here we got 10-10 to that race, 567 days. And, of course, Nebuzaradan, his guard, pitched for 4 days and burnt down the houses from 5-7 to 5-10. But today's also 40 days from 229, the rest waypoint. And I talked about 40 days of that prophecy being Moses' 40th day, which is 427. Truly remarkable. But the 10-10 waypoint was the first waypoint he sent me with. We're back on 115 of called January 15, 2011, the video. Talk about 110. And also 10-10. It's also the day he describes to us the five points of his Ezekiel 24 sign. That is his promise that he sent me. It's one of those, it's simplicity. It's the simplest thing, more simple than Daniel chapter 10 is Ezekiel 24. When one escapes from the captivity, referring to Mr. Babylon, comes to you, announces this five-point sign to your ear, for you cover your head, not more lament for the destruction of the bride of Christianity's make-believe Messiah, only rather more lament for your own abominations, to not cover your mustache, which means to cry aloud and spare not with me, and also to no longer be the leprous life of Adam, because the leper covers his lip and says, unclean, unclean, but no longer cover your upper lip or your mustache, to stop eating the bread of men, which the doctrines of Saul of Tarsus and all the false doctrines of his followers and such, and put your shoes on your feet for the second Exodus. When one comes to you with the 5 points of this sign, you can know that I'm Adonai Yahweh. That's what he says. It's his promise. That's pretty simple. That's pretty simple. That's simplicity. That's why he threw that simplicity in there on that number four slot. Yeah, I said I hit the jackpot big time. And you're about ready to realize that. Powerball that night went up 8 zillion was all, which is low. But I talked about all the emphasis I put on 8-12 that day for my birth waypoint and the 266 days that was the plumb line 594 days earlier from the previous draw. But all the talk I put on 8-12, he caused the Powerball to go up 8, therefore went down 12 that night. Say what? I put a lot of emphasis in those two videos on 8-12. So much so I started off the video adding to the previous video about 8-12. Because I wanted to let it sink home. And that night he caused it to go up 8 zillion, down 12. For that 266 day, which was, my 266 day was 11-9, of course. There's day number 309 I talked about at the beginning of this video. So it was 51 zillion on day number That draw on day number 153 for the three sets of 51 men. The Hosea setback is 51 zillion on when we were T-minus 153 to the 910 delivery waypoint. So it went up 8 to 59 zillion for Isaiah 59. The last verse says there's going to come a time when that which I speak, or my seed speaks, or my seed speak, is not going to depart. So that means that I'm going to be able to say, I would never be into gambling. I'd be able to say, I want 12-14-03 as a trifecta. Well, I want 687 as a trifecta. And they'll hit. Whichever I say, whatever I say. But it's just about, the jackpot is coming. Isaiah 59 says so. And of course, I wouldn't ever use it for gambling. But whatever I speak is going to come to pass. And that's just reality, because it's a cheating moment is at hand. But 59 zillion plus 86 zillion for the millions of following nights, 145. Day number 145 is 525. Wait a minute, that was the day of court case number 81. For my face is shining for the 321 prison mattress. 321 hit the race, blah, blah, blah. Go on and on and on. That day they resulted in my value determiner of Isaiah 22, setting the 1,500 shekel purchase price, the $1,500 purchase price on my head. Those 1,500 shekels of Yahweh's holy anointing oil. The fourth anointing, by the way, was on 318 when the holy anointing oil was mixed. That would have been a year and a few months prior when the holy anointing was mixed before the arrest. But truly amazing. You know how amazing it gets? I'll go ahead and tell you. Mr. Raven, up there in the wind, showing off. Because they do show off in the wind. It's quite amazing what they can do in the wind. But anyway, 86 zillion was 86 zillion is a 449.1 cash value. Excuse me, a 49.1 cash value as the 86 zillion for tomorrow night. But it was set on day number 491. I told you whenever that race was on day number 492, and I told you that the numbers for when that nine hit, the calculation for that hit totaled 492. Well, the night before, he set on day number 491, meaning day number 490 from the third dove, that tier of the 490. Day number 491, it was set at 49.1 on that night, because then after the draw, they set the next total. The cash value was set at 491. Then the next day was day number 492 on that 490. I'm just saying the 490 that's at hand with the 7 days I talked about at the beginning of this video is just unreal. With the 7 days, it takes us to three and a half ways, because it says that the anointed, I'm going to get to that, but the anointed cuts, not for himself, but a covenant for 7 days. And then the sacrifice ends, my sacrifice, my affliction ends halfway through it on 411. Anyway, that 1125, 390, 490 waypoint, 1125 is datum of 325 for that 325-gallon water tank in the dream, which I'm going to get to with that serial number, 12-14-03-687. And, of course, the 406 waypoint when that was set was the 3 smooth star anniversary, the 1335th day. Hang in there, because I am on the last quarter panel of 8. Full page here. As a matter of fact, I didn't have room to write, so it's going to get a little tough to read. But 924 plus 195 is today. Struggle number 195 is Uli, the Uli River of Daniel chapter 8, the wonderful number, those 2300 morning and evenings, 1150 days. I'm getting quite the show of ravens here. They're gathering around me here because they do know I'm Elijah after all. But 195 for Uli, that's today's 409 waypoint, the famine prevailed and the city broken up waypoint. But the wonderful number, 1150. Subtract 1150 from today, it was 316. I talked about the 316s in last video. 316 of 2019, which was 129 of 6,000, the day that brought his servant Abraham into the world on 129, and it was the 1260th day encompassing the Virgin of the Sky sign was 129, and it's the 29th day of the year for the 29 knives. But that day was the 170th Sabbath for the 17 shekels, but for $170 bought into the second GoFundMe's house campaign and other things as well. It was the 168th Silver Trumpet Assembly for the 168 days of the day, and the 7 days of the hour, of course, are the 7 days that cut short to 6 days. It was the 200th day of his altar being uncovered for the 200-mile-long river, the Jordan, I'm going to cross. The depth, they're going to flow to the depth of the blood, of the depth of a horse's bridle. A horse's bridle, we're talking about the racehorses. To 1,600 furlongs, it's 200 miles. Do the arithmetic. A furlong is an eighth of a mile. I got 8 quarter panels even, I told you about. Jam-packed. Well, Reb Sheke came to see, to tell us to leave that day because we were foreclosed upon for the second stroke that day. We were foreclosed upon on 11-1. So that would have been 2 months and 28 days after the foreclosure. 78 days for 318. Anyway, Reb Sheke's second stroke of coming, Reb Sheke of the Hezekiah prophecy, second stroke out of four where he came to harass us. Plus 30 days later was the 229 arrest. Hosea 5:7, the wine, the 30 days, because he says you've begotten children, they're strangers gateway. And therefore a month is going to devour you. And now we have 30 days of no wine here ending tonight. Yesterday, speaking of the number of Sabbaths, yesterday is the 521st Sabbath, paralleling the 521st Silver Trumpet Assembly, paralleling the 521 Elijah Dream Waypoint, which I'm going to expand upon. Sabbath number 323, Mordecai got the signature ring, that 55 signature ring, on 323 to reverse the course. It was silent number 176 for the 176 verses, of those eight verses per 22 stanzas of Psalms 119. What brought me in the world on 11-9. But, and I told a man recently, is that you or anybody else on the planet Earth, those 176 verses, who do they describe? Do you really say they describe you when you can't even live by one word that he sent forth from his mouth? No, that's a man that hungers and thirsts for Gateway's Torah, his straight and narrow pathway, and does it. That's just reality. Those verses even say I'm being afflicted in your stead when you look up a few words. That's just reality. Psalms 119, 176 verses. Silent number 176. Truly, truly amazing. Daniel chapter 9, the 521. This is where, 521 plus 1,396 days. The Elijah dream on 521 plus 1,396. 3,396 means to prevail. And this is amazing. One of the 24 places it's used is in Daniel chapter 9. It says the covenant will prevail for 7 days. So it means that nothing's going to happen probably until after these 7 days. But the covenant will prevail. But the 3.5 days is about my affliction coming to an end. So that's interesting, which is 7:34 p.m. on 4/11, which would be 5/11. But 3.5 days. But the covenant will prevail. They translate it. They translate it, he will confirm the covenant, is how they translate it. But the covenant prevail, that's 1396 and 521 plus 1396 was that race. And today's 1398, but for Valiant Man, but 1396 for that race and that last draw. That 5:28 draw with for 148 for that 148th running of the run for the roses, boy they smell good. Anyway, today's T minus 151 days. Day number 151, 601. 601 plus 308 is the seventh Sabbath from the Waymovers. 308, 601 plus 308 is today. 308 plus 31 is. 31 Kings west of the Jordan is today. And so because it's 30 to 309, I had a bottle of wine. So, excuse me. So 31 for the 31 Kings west of the Jordan, east to west, the Jordan Valley. It's called the Loaf. It's called the Loaf of the Jordan. It's not called the Valley. Actually, it's called the Loaf of the Jordan, the Kikar of the Jordan. Anyway, that guy's in Zechariah 5. I got to keep moving. But 5:7 to 5:10, those 4 days. I told you it's 5:10 plus 5:67 for Amorite and 10:10 plus 5:70. And I think it might mean truth. One of the words for truth, I have to look. But 409, the last night of wine, it'll be 409 plus 28. Excuse me, today's 409 waypoint plus 28 plus 31. I covered that for those 4 days. I'm not going to do that again. Got the beginning of the video. 5:9 on Satan's calendar for tonight's 59 zillion. Nice touch. for Russia's 77th anniversary with the 77 times of Lamech versus the 14 of Cain. I talked about the last video. But 5-9 of the Danites calendar is a day that 1,440, record number back then a few years ago, were at the gathered at the Western Wall singing for the Messiah, the anointed. And the Messiah means anointed. He's standing before your faces. 1,440 of them for 4 years. Yeah, be kidding me. 1,440 days is four years on Maker's Restored calendar. 1,440, record number of Danites gathered at the Western Wall singing for the Messiah. And here he's standing before the face. Matter of fact, they sent me back on a plane when I went to go scatter my hair at that same wall, the Western Wall. I get to Tel Aviv for those 7 hours, the nanosecond. I was going to Jerusalem to scatter my hair at the last one-third of my hair that I shaved off on the 124 microwave point of Daniel chapter 10, 21. 124 is actually mentioned a few verses earlier, but it's referring to the 20, or maybe the verse, anyway, so it's referring to that day. 507 of 6001, the great Meher Shalal Kishbaz Mir, this race was on 507 of Satan's calendar, and the last draw was on 507. 507 began the 4 days of them rolling Yahweh's house into the heap of his witness. And they had a party. And that Elijah dream, and I will finally get into the Elijah dream, they had a party, because I could hear them partying up there, and they were laughing and everything else, and they might even have some fireworks, I can't remember. They were laughing and everything else, they were having a party. But in that Elijah dream, which is years before the property's foreclosed upon, I had a dream. I was in Bertha, in our old black truck, and I was going up a hill, the hill, Yahweh's house, and I had the 325-gallon water tank that we had in the back of it, and I had a mattress on the top of it. That way, I don't know if it's a steamboat mattress, because the steamboat mattress came into play at the same time as the thing, or the prison mattress, the 321 mattress that came into play years later when I was arrested, a couple years later I was arrested. But anyway, I was going up the hill, and I got there to where I was going up the top of the hill, and the people of the subdivision that I knew, I recognized them, they were having a party, having a big barbecue. So I started backing down the hill. I just backed away because I didn't want to turn around, and I also had a bunch of garbage bags on the back. I'm flying down this hill, and the brakes went out, and I'm backing up fast as I can. I go across the cattle guard, and as I cross the cattle guard, I don't know how I slowed down enough to notice that the banding tool for the circumcision, if we will, but for the castration of the goats and the sheep that we had, but the banding tool was in there that we'd been missing, was in underneath the grates, and something else, wife would be able to remind me, I think. Anyway, if not, I got it talked about in the video, and I turned sharp to go up the hill to stop, so because I was flying with no brakes. So then I started going forward again, but I went down to the intersection, and there was a fork, and I turned left, and I was on the phone. Oh, no, not yet. I think I was on the phone with one of the wives at that point, and I hung up the phone, and I started going left, and I was going up to the 409 camp, and there was a turnoff to the left there to where you fork off to where we were camped at the 409 for today's 409 waypoint, and I never got that till just now, because I hadn't talked about the dream until just now. So I haven't thought about it even, but that was on the 409 where we were camped. We were stowed in there for those like 5 months or so. I mean, can't remember. We were stowed in for quite a while. Anyway, because they closed down the road, it's a long story. But he provided at 9,500 feet. We were 9,500 feet. Anyway, there's a fork in the road, but I know I'm going to lose connection when I get to that fork at the 409. So But I get a phone call from Elijah. That's why I called a phone call from Elijah right before that. I'm talking to him. So I knew I was going to get, so I pulled over. And because what happened was the mattress crushed the 325-gallon tank. So I had to pull over. I knew I was going to get disconnected anyway. So I pulled over to look at the damage, and it's just crushed. And I'm talking to him and everything. And he says, when you ask Gateway for things, do you ask with confidence? And I said, thought to myself, probably not enough, and he hung up on me. Now, I haven't thought about the details of that dream until now, so I might be missing something. But anyway, so then I got in, went up the road, and turned at the 409. But the steamboat mattress, or a mattress, so it was a steamboat or the prison mattress, 321 prison mattress, but the mattress crushed the 325-gallon water tank. And really what happened with these... these dual trifectas is 687 and 121403. as Elijah's water tank was crushed. It's just a reality. But you can't crush my spirit, because my spirit ain't Medina's spirit. My spirit's Shapeway's spirit. Seven eyes that are upon me, and it can't be crushed, because I look at all these now. 1870 for pathway, like a pathway. 1870 videos with this video, and the proof that he sent me. If you didn't even believe the testimony of his word, which I believe. You could certainly believe all the amazing things like you just heard with this this race and stuff and the draw that night. You certainly could believe that, couldn't you, if you don't even believe his word. So see, you're without excuse. That's just reality. But today, to Striking It Rich, day number 21,731 of my life, Striking It Rich now. 21,731. So I looked at it at about 714 months on Satan's calendar, which is 190, Strong's number, day number 714 is day number 194, which 194 is the same as day number 195 for Eli. You got to be kidding me. The same words. I mean, perhaps peradventure, perhaps Shapeway is going to do this. Shapeway, if you go there to Sodom and Gomorrah and you find five lacking, perhaps you'll find five lacking. Peradventure, you'll find five lacking. We destroy it for 45's sake. Yeah, I'll destroy it for 45. I won't do it for 45's sake, he says. Goes all the way down to 10. 10. 10, those reductions down to 10, from 45 to 40 to 30 to 20 to 10. 10, they're doubling the 10 in the two bonus balls, the recent bonus balls for 10. It goes down to 10. But it's the same word for Eli, the Eli River of Daniel chapter 8, the wonderful numberer. That's what that palmoni means. A certain one, it's they translate it, a certain saint or something. But it's palmoni, it means wonderful number. But anyway, 714 months parallels the one day number Eli, because 194 and 195 are the same. But 21,731, so he caused me to divide it by some numbers, and I still have yet Googled it up to find the factors, but I picked a few numbers to Google it. The standard factors I always do are 7 and 3, and it didn't divide. I was really surprised with the emphasis he put upon day, especially with the lie as you dream with that 409 road, which that I didn't even thought about till just a few minutes ago in this video. And all of a sudden, I divide it by a random number, 31, because of, and it was actually, I think, before the notes this video, too, but I was just trying for the 31 kings and different things, but I divided by it, but it ain't a normal number for me to divide it by. And I found a way to do it. You just Google it the other day. I found that out. That's a lot easier. But I did not do that with this. Excuse me. Still to date, I haven't Googled the factors of 21,731, but I probably will now after doing the video. If not, Alma will cover it for me. But, anyway, the factor of it is 31. 31 divides into 21,731. How many times? 701 times. The day Yeshua was born in the world. The memorial of acclamation, 701. That's called, what's it called? The Day of Trumpets. That's a mistranslation. It's the memorial of acclamations. 701. Well, I even talked about 7010, which 701 is a tithe of that, in the last video with the total reductions. Now the total reductions have went up. And so it went to 714, 7014 minus another up 8 minus 12. So it'd be 7026 now, is that right? 7026. But anyway, I talked about that video. I was 7010, which a tithe of that, of course, is 701. But wow. And in 7010, I talked about how that's used with the decree, 7010 of the decree, the 30-day decree of Daniel, with that approaching with that three, we approach it three times a day. Talked about earlier in this video, 30-day decree of him not being able to approach anybody besides, and I said Nebuchadnezzar that prophecy, and think about it, that's Daniel chapter 6, so I'm not even sure if Nebuchadnezzar is in Daniel chapter 6, that might be Darius at that point, but I might have made a mistake there, I have to look. But anyway, but nobody besides the king, he couldn't petition anybody besides the king for 30 days, that decree, and got him thrown in the lion's den. Of course, that worked out not so well for his accusers. But 7010 is that word for the decree, the king's decree, the royal decree. Wow, and how it ties into this 30th night with no wine tonight. Big, big, big. 19th night of the darkness. Big, big, big. All big. The race, big, big, big. But forget all these wonderful details that I've talked about, the wonderful numbers talked about in these now pathway 1870 videos. Forget that. Just believe the simplicity of Daniel 10:21, or the simplicity of Ezekiel 24, or the simplicity of several other, many other verses like that that I've shared throughout these videos, including these wonderful details, these wonderful nuggets that he's given me to give to you guys. But and they're in every news story, everything. This might be a new world record for the longest video I've done, so be it. But wow, it is simple indeed. In dying, you're going to die if you don't turn back to him through that which he's restored. That's simplicity.